Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. So here are a bunch of drawer fronts that Maggie's made. And here are several more. And this is pretty much what's left of our dried lumber that we've made on our HM126. And this set of sawhorse brackets right there was totally full. So it is time to go out and get some more food for the mill. So today we're out here to get some more logs for our mill so that we can finish our house. And we had a big storm come through and it knocked down about 4 nice hard maple trees, and we're gonna go harvest them.
Oh yeah.
The only problem we've got is to get to them, we had to come down a big hill, and then also with this storm damage, this is a big limb off of a beech tree. There's the beech tree. You can see it from the sun. But we came back here about a week ago to try to get these, and this one was about 8 feet in the air.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a really nice maple, and I can get for sure 2 10-foot logs, maybe 3. But it's also probably one of the most dangerous trees we've cut so far, because this root ball may stand right where it's at. It may want to go that way, which would be okay. If it wants to come this way, it'd be a dangerous spot to be in. So I'm going to cut this through, and we're going to start watching to see if that moves at all. And if it doesn't, we'll continue cutting. And if it does, we'll figure out another plan. I'm gonna try and do this without getting my feet wet, because I'm kind of standing in a creek. But you can see, as I started cutting down through here, by the time I got to here, I saw this crack starting to widen out, which told me either this piece was going down, which can't do because it's on that bank, or that stump was starting to rock back just a little bit. So I would almost preferred it not move at all, but if it's gonna move at all, moving away is the best way.
Hey everybody. I'm gonna have him try and push this back. I don't know if it'll go or not, but if we lay it down, we don't ever have to worry about which way it might fall on somebody later. So we're gonna try it. We'll see what happens.
Okay, and our mill can do a 10 foot too, so I cut them right at 10 foot because no reason to push it. Get two then, because this 10 foot section just beyond that, a big limb comes off, so probably won't get a third, but we got a really good two. There are a lot of copperheads and rattlesnakes down here, even though I've never seen one. Everybody tells me there are, so I stomp my feet. So you can see we got the tractor stuck. We brought the skid steer down to try and get it unstuck. And we'll get these logs out here with a chain and drag them. All right, well, that worked really well. Nice job driving the tractor.
Thanks.
Hey, you got it unstuck. I was the one who got it stuck.
For a second there, I thought it was gonna come
up. Yeah, it came up out of that rut first.
Yeah, it came up, it leveled out pretty quick, but for a minute there, I considered jumping.
Always jump to the outside.
Yeah, I was going that way.
So here are the holes. And I really think it was this front tire in this giant one that's about 2 foot deep. But we got her out. And I'm going to take and smooth these ruts out with a skid steer. And we'll get that log drug up with a chain. So we've got two maple logs here. We've got two more big trees over there and another one in that mess. And we're going to try and harvest as many of these as we can. I just didn't anticipate this ground being this soft down here. This is mid-August, so usually it's a little drier around here this time of year. This around the trunk of this tree so I cut off, and before I stepped down here I was looking for snakes because there's a bunch around. Well, look at that geode.
Very nice.
It's just laying there in the creek bed.
Alrighty.
And no snakes.
Very nice. Always a good thing when there are no snakes.
I prefer it. My thought is I'll cut it off here, but I'm going to go ahead and loop this on so I can pull it out.
Yeah, I think that's brilliant. Just don't cut it.
I won't cut the strap. Maybe. Hopefully.
Oh, I can't wait to film the next segment.
And then I'm going to try and make it 20 foot long.
Yeah, don't even get near that water. We have brain-eating amoeba in some of the water around here, so.
So this is some shallow, stagnant water, and it's been super hot, and they've been putting warnings out about a brain-eating amoeba that lives and produces in that kind of water, so I'm going to stay out of it. I already don't have much brain.
We'd like them not to be chewing on it.
I saw it wanting to go that way, is why I came over here.
Chainsaw.
don't know if we'll be able to pick those both up together, but we're gonna try. I found you people. I knew that was gonna knock off there. Okay, well, we'll see what else we got. Okay, here are our four maple logs that we harvested down there from storm damage. So we're gonna cut these up on the mill tomorrow, and then these will become some of our doors for our bedrooms and closets. And I think we already have the bathroom doors. So thanks a lot for watching. Hope you liked it. Have a great day and be safe.